What is SEO?
SEO.
SEO. I get asked this question a lot, and I love to answer it. No, I'm serious. But I always give a different answer. I don't know why. So, I wanted to answer it once and for all in 7 minutes and give you 4 SEO tools so you can start doing SEO today. Let's get to it. Timer, please. Please. SEO stands for Search Engine Optimization, and it's the job of making constant specific actions to make your website, video, app, or whatever more visible in search engines. So, what is a search engine?
No, I forgot to turn the light.
Well, it's a program that allows you to search for things and identify items in a database. Or basically, somewhere where you can search for and find things. Anything really. Like YouTube, Bing, or Google. That's the top dog.
In many studies, it has been shown that the top 3 ranking websites in Google get more than 35% of the clicks.
Okay. Let's focus on Google. You want to rank your website in Google so more people can see it, right? Well, to do that, you need to know how Google decides how to rank websites. First, Google tries to understand what your page is about. Then, they try to evaluate if your page is relevant and valuable. They do this because they need to make sure that your page answers the intention of the user who uses their service. I mean, that's why you use Google, right? To look for answers. So, the more of these two, the higher your page will rank. To measure this, they use algorithms and artificial intelligence that take into account more than 200 factors. Ranking factors, like keywords on your page, where these words are, how people interact on your page, if other websites link to your website, and many, many more. So, you have your website and you create pages, but you're not going to stand there and wait for Google to rank your pages.
I'm just waiting for mine.
You're going to do SEO to make your pages easy to understand for Google and to adapt them to their ranking factors so they can rank high. I'll tell you in a bit how to do this. Google wants to offer people exactly what they want to see, and you want people to see your website. So, if you optimize your website for Google, you are optimizing it too for people, real people. And you will be rewarded with higher rankings and more visibility. It's a cycle. An obvious but very important question. Why do you want your website more visible in Google? Simple. Your business plus more eyes equals a higher percentage of success. And success is what you want, my friend. But wait, here is where the real SEO power comes. These are not just any eyes on your website. The people who will see your website are searching for you. Your website is in a search engine, remember? So they are interested in you. They are your potential clients. Or in other words, people who could potentially end up buying from you if you show them what they want. Okay, Alex, but how do I target my potential clients with SEO? How can I know what people search for so I can make pages that answer the questions? Well, it's simple. There are more than 3.5 billion searches every day in Google. Yes, billion, that's a lot. So surely there must be some of those searches that are somewhat related to what you offer, right? One of the tasks when you do SEO is to find out what people are searching for and how many times they search for it. And you can do this for free. Yes, with tools like this. I'll leave the link in the description. I also showed in my last video how to do it. Click on the card. I don't know what it is, left or right. Once you know this, you have the power. So you can literally create pages in your website that are relevant and valuable to them. And what does relevant and valuable do? Rank you high in Google. Okay. So what do my potential clients search in Google? Let's see. Your potential clients, when they search in Google, they are in different steps on their journey to buy from you. Some know what they want and others not quite yet. And some are in the middle. Let's visualize this. Wait, let's keep some space. This is the SEO funnel. I have divided this journey in 4 steps. Awareness, interest, consideration, and buy. To keep things short, in awareness, people don't really know what they want yet, but they're looking for information. And in buying, well, they want to buy. But to give you a clear idea, I'm going to show you examples of what people search in each step. Let's see what people search if you're a state agent, or a beauty center, or a tax consultant. Any business works. Don't worry if you didn't see them. I have the examples in my website. I want to keep this video in 7 minutes, remember. Imagine every time someone searches for something, whether it's information, buying, comparing products, knowing about a specific thing, looking for your local store, if you have a store. If your business and website manages to show up in the 4 buying stages, you can be sure that you're offering real value to your potential clients. And this will result in them buying from you. Money, 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 money. And lastly, and finally, why is SEO so effective? Simple, because people have already stated that they need you with what they've searched. So you don't have to look for them, they come to you. Aha! So, summarizing everything into one sentence, reaching targeted people who could potentially end up buying from you exactly when they are searching for you and answering their needs makes the possibility of them buying from you extremely high. Extremely! And that's it. Now, if you want to do SEO and learn how to do it for free, you know how, right? Follow me on YouTube because I have so many new video ideas coming, and I also have a free SEO newsletter. Basically, in this weekly newsletter, I'm gonna send you for free, all the SEO resources like articles and videos I have used myself to learn SEO that week. So I just find things, learn, get those things, put them in a newsletter and send it to you for free. You want that? The link is in the description. And don't forget to like and follow me on YouTube. Peace!